reckon I got an idea why you've come here, my friend. I'll lend you a hand.
What up, y'all? It's your boy, Taker. Are you ready to become the great Wukong? I got you covered. Stick around to the end for sweet, sweet 45-second revenge on Wandering Right in NG+. As usual, the build and chapters will be in the description.
Alrighty. You wanna beat this guy? This is how I did it. First, I have my stamina built up. I have my martial arts built up. For survival, I have robust constitution. Each talent level moderately increases maximum health. So that's good. Wrathful escalation. Each talent's level slightly increases critical hit chance. That's always good. For my stances, I'm only using smash stance, so I have that pretty high. I have all the side ones pretty high as well. For my mysticism, I'm using ring of fire, so you want that up as high as possible. For my alterations, I'm using cloud step, so I have that up pretty high. For my transformations, it's just average. Just in case I use it. Pretty much when I use it, it's to reset and get away and conserve some health. For my relics under Craving Eyes, I have keen eyesight. Considerably increases critical hit damage. For Fuming Ears, Whistling Wind temporarily increases attack after perfect dodge. Hubris Nose in one breath. Focus points can be charged up to 4 within Ring of Fire. Always good. Envious Toungue, refreshing taste, after consuming medicine increases the critical hit chance of the next attack. Critical hit chance is a big one in this build. Grieved Body, everlasting vitality, considerably increases maximum health. Always good. Using a Jingubang Staff, using the fan, and Big Head Boss Baby. For my armor, I'm using Gold Feng-Tail Crown, Gold Susie Armor, Dian Kui Long Soaring Bracers, Lotus Silk Cloud Treaders. For my curios, I'm using a Tridacna Pendant. Slightly reduces cooldown of all spells. Using Tablet of 3, considerably increases critical hit chance when health is low. Just in case. I'm using the Water Orb. Considerably increases defense in water. This one's pretty important for this battle. We're fighting in water the whole time. I'm using the Jade Guanyin Gourd, using Long Aura Amplification Pellets, Life-Saving Pill, Longevity Decoction. The Life-Saving Pill, if he's low on health, I'm low on health, I'm using it. I have a video of the Life-Saving Pill if you need to find the recipe and create them. Check out my videos. For my brew, I'm using the Sunset of Nine Skies. Each sip recovers 35% of maximum health, grants a considerable amount of chi. That's always good. Gotta build up the focus, gotta build up all that good stuff. I'm using Breath of Fire for Cloud Step. Goji Shoots moderately extends the duration of the next Ring of Fire. Always good. Steel Ginseng instantly gains moderate amount of focus. With that, you should be able to whoop his ass. Whip it. Whip it good and become the master Wukong. So you can get the new game plus, go in, beat the cicada, go to the big head boss base and beat him like he stole your lunch money. Let's end this. Phase 1. You will always be able to get the first hit, so charge your focus to 4. After the attack, jump forward. This will prevent him from using his Ring of Fire. Dodge his light attack and time his glowing staff. If you go for distance in the fight, be ready for him to throw his staff and dodge left or right. He'll do a spin before throwing it. If he is mid-distance or you start your combo, keep going. Usually the last hit will close the distance to finish the combo and give damage. Not very many talk about this, but you can use his Ring of Fire to gain focus.
Big head boss, baby!
When a staff starts to glow, you need to time each of those attacks. They start fast and then they start to hesitate.
For the big glowing red attacks, take a beat and then dodge. If you are sick of doing your light attack and it goes invisible on you, you can jump and attack him as well. Mix in your heavy if you have focus built up. If you only build your heavy, he'll just move out of the way most of the time. When he steps back into his thrust stance, wait for the staff to glow red, and you can dodge left or right, or way back. That's phase one. Phase 2 is more of the same, but heavier and quicker. At the beginning of phase 2, he does the same move. You'll have to put your focus back on him and time the attack and dodge left or right. If you need to heal, do it now, you have a small window. When you hear that thumping sound and he lifts his leg, dodge left or right and he won't immobilize you. Sometimes in phase 2 you'll be able to quickly launch the full focus attack. You can use it right before he starts the combo. You'll take some damage, but hey, so is he. He will take your gourd and empty it to one use. Here I use cloud step to use the gourd, but there is another trick. Use the gourd and then immediately dodge left or right and he won't steal your drink. Outside of cloud step, I could never figure out a way to dodge all of these. I think I just couldn't get the timing right. Dodge left or right just before the glowing attack. I think we're the same, huh? When he's on the cloud, keep moving and dodge. Waiting for him to finish. Missed it. His health is down low enough to use his fan. While the fans go and chip away at his health and build the focus. If you need to reset and save some health, and possibly get the hits in, use a transformation. Go. Heart's pounding. Hands are sweaty. Knees weak. Could this be it? Ring of fire for health and build focus. Dodging in and out of the ring of fire to continue getting focused. Booyah, bitch! Stick around for the wandering right.
You must have heard tales about him. Some say he helped Tongue Monk fetch the scriptures, was granted Buddhahood, and stayed on Mount Lingshan thereafter. Some say it was not him who was granted Buddhahood. The real him was already dead on the journey to the west. Some say that the journey never happened. He is nothing but a monkey who lives in some storyteller's tall tale. But now, you will hear a tale which no one has ever known.
Mm-hmm.